Hey guys, when you're on your mission, it is easy to get caught up in where you're going and be so focused on a destination that you forget to enjoy the journey. I was guilty of this sometimes for sure. I want you to really celebrate your milestones along the way. Major one for me was making $100,000 in a year for the first time. When I did, I purchased my first house that did not include any rental income. I remember a friend of mine telling me, Hoggy, my nickname at the time, when you're making some serious money, which you are now, you should be living in a nice house, not some dilapidated duplex. I was about 27 years old and I purchased a 1.5-story home in a nice neighborhood that was completely finished for about $220,000. I kept the duplex that I purchased as it was a great positive cash flow after I rented out the unit I was living in. The duplex served its purpose on my mission, but I had grown out of it. The duplex allowed me to save more and more and live very affordably. However, I would always have work to do on it. I wanted to be in a place where I could come home and truly relax. In my duplex, after hard days of work, all I could think about was, I have to finish that. The deck still needs to be stained. It needs to be painted. I gotta fix the kitchen. Oh, cracking the six-figure mark in income for me was a huge milestone. It was something I always knew I could do, but when I did, I knew I would always do it again and again. I came to the understanding that I will not get rich or make much money at all doing renovations. I suck at them. Even with my dad, when we would spend quality time together, I think we were more frustrated with each other than actually enjoying the process. He was a measure three times and cut once type of guy, where I was a don't measure at all, cut it quick and make it fit kind of person. You can imagine how well our rentals looked. Most of the stuff we did, I had to pay someone to redo it. I should have listened to my dad more back then. It probably would have saved me a lot of money. The point is that you need to reward yourself in such a way that it makes you a better you. If it is a memory that you want to make by taking your entire family away on a cruise, then by all means do it. That memory and the joy it will bring you will last for a lifetime and give you the motivation to do it again, or even better, to do it again bigger. The rewards do not have to be material either. It could be a donation to a charity you've always wanted to give. You just need to do it. And no matter what, it will make you feel like $1,000,000. The accountability assignment. I want you to download the Mission Milestones template and fill it out. I want you to pick three major milestones that you want to accomplish on your journey and how you're going to celebrate them when you hit them. Have some fun with this. However, as part of it, you also need to keep the budget in mind for it as well. My celebration was to have a completely finished house to call my own with no tenants. It was not to have the big house I live in today. Have fun with this assignment and do some thinking about it as well. Talk to your inner circle, including your friends. You just might motivate someone else, or better yet, start a race with someone, which will really keep you accountable. Keep focused on the mission and make this a fabulous day.